Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Today, we would like to present our assignment 1, which is ISO 9001 from our subject quality management. First of all, I would like to thank our lecturer, Sir Effendi Ong Bin Siam. And secondly, I would like to present my group members. My name is Muhammad Asif bin Muhammad Rizwan. My group members is Izzati Hayani binti Abdul Razak, Afif Iqmal bin Muhammad, Muhammad Hilman bin Hishamuddin, Nurul Faridina Ilana binti Azmi. First, I would like to introduce about the ISO 9001. What does ISO 9001 means? ISO 9001 is well defined as the international standard that specifies requirement for a quality management system. Second, to show the ability to continuously provide goods and services that satisfy consumer and regulatory criteria, organization apply this standard. ISO 9001 certification ensures that quality orientation is carried out by every employee on a daily basis. Fourth, organizations of all types and sizes have found that using ISO 9001 standards helps them organize processes and improve process efficiency. There are several reasons why organizations should be certified with ISO 9001. First, to have a strong customer orientation by aligning the customer needs and interest parties. Second, to have an effective communication driven by a communication strategy. Third, to have a better understanding of harmonization terminology such as context, risk and performance. Fourth, to have a uniform structure of an organization. High level structure facilitates certification to other standards. Fifth, to support the management by having more commitment from executives. Sixth, integration into a business strategy by improving harmonization with the strategy objective. 7. Simplifying implementation in the respective organization. Now, I would like to tell about the history when ISO 9001 was introduced. In 1917, the idea that quality management system could influence the quality of a product or service was first introduced in the 1917. In 1987 to 1994, ISO first published its ISO 9001 standard in 1987 and then released the latest version in 1994. In 2008 and 2015, to address the changing needs of its user, ISO again updates its standard in 2000 and 2008 and further in 2015. For the objective, there are several objectives of ISO 9001, which are: first, to establish effective quality management in an organization; second, as a guidance principle that can be used to create efficiencies by aligning and streamlining process throughout the organization; third, to lower the cost and create new opportunities that meet regulatory requirements and help organization expand into new markets in which client demands ISO 9001 certification. Scope of ISO 9001. There are three scopes of ISO 9001. External and internal problem relating to the organization mission, the strategy, and the ability to achieve the expected outcome. Second, requirements of relevant stakeholders. Third, the organization goods and services. Now, I would like to pass to Afif Iqmal for the methodology.
Assalamualaikum, my name is Afif Iqmal. Next, I will continue with the methodology in ISO 9001. So, ISO 9001 is using process approach as the methodology. So what is process approach? Process approach is process technique to improve customer loyalty by enhancing customer need by designing, integrating and enhancing the performance of a quality control system. So how? So this process approach is using two techniques, which is plan, do, check, act, or we call PDCA cycle, and risk-based thinking. And why we use process approach? The first one is to track how the process is performing. The second is to recognize and implement enhance in the process. And third, to realize there are certainly those improve after change have been made. Next, we go to the second slide. So, process approach to the quality management system are allow. The first one is allow to understanding and consistency in meeting requirement. Second, allow to do the consideration of operation in terms of value added. Third is able to provide effective process performance. And lastly, can enhancement of process focus on information and data. Next, I will explain more detail about the PDCA cycle. So the PDCA cycle have four steps. The first one is plan, second do, third is a check, and lastly act, or we call action. So the first step model is to carry out a change and can be considered as project planning tool. So for the planning stage is to identify and analyze the existing problem or the opportunity, and then we can proceed to plan a change. And then second do step is to implement what was planned. In other words, is to test the change or solution based on planning. Third is check to evaluate the planning is working well or not. And lastly, act, which is action, to improve the system and process performance where possible. So why we use the PDCA cycle? The first one is PDCA framework work well in all type of organization. Second, it can use to tackle and identify solution to problem and to improve business process. And third, it can saving time and money. And lastly, can enhancement and persistence of the business are more assured. So the PDCA cycle is used when we want to carry out a new improvement or implementing any change on the project. Is used when we want to develop a new or improve a process, product or service. Used when we want to do the planning, the collection and analysis of data to verify and prioritize problem or cost. And it's also can use when to implement continuous improvement, defining a repetitive work process, and also can use when planning, implementing and checking compliance. So the next figure show the relationship between the clauses of ISO 9001 with PDCA cycle. So as we can see in the plan stage have the clauses contact of the organization, leadership, planning and support. In do step have the clauses operation. In check step have clauses performance and evaluation. And at or action stage have clauses continual improvement. Next, we go to the second technique or approach, which is risk-based thinking in ISO 9001 version 2015. Before this, the others or the previous version doesn't have the risk-based thinking approach. So this approach is to establish, to consider risk. The risk-based thinking means that all risks are recognized, taken into consideration and controlled throughout the design and use of the quality management system. And risk-based thinking is used to improve customer confidence and certification, ensure consistency of quality of product or and service. So the benefit of risk-based thinking is can reduce the probability of negative result, ensure greater knowledge of risk, and improve preparedness. So the next slide will show the process of implement risk-based thinking. The first one, we need to understand the risk. The second, we plan the action to eliminate the risk. Third is implement, which is the action. Next, we check effective of the action, effective or not. And then lastly, improve, we learn from the experience. So that's all for the methodology part. Next, I will pass to my friend to for the others part.
Okay, assalamualaikum. So for the chapter 3 literature review, process approach in ISO 9001. It being based in Switzerland, ISO is the international standardization specialized organization and the source of ISO 9000. It was founded in 1947. It is comprised of 140 countries, national standards bodies that working together to create over 13,000 international market principles, society and government. As international, the outcome of ISO technical work are published standards. One of the standards in the ISO 9000 family is ISO 9001. So deals on ISO 9001, organization must satisfy the criteria that they choose to reach the norm. So worldwide, more than a million companies are individually certified, making ISO 9001 one of the world's most used management tools. The globally recognized standard ISO 9001 quality management standard is for the monitoring of the quality of companies. Customer will find that order are delivered regularly on schedule and to the right specification. And lastly, in order to increase opportunities, deals will open up the marketplace. Okay, so that's all from me. Thank you.
Okay, I am Nur Farina Hidayana, and now I will explain about results, which is there are three processes involved in ISO 9001. The first one is risk-based thinking, second one is PDCA, and the process approach. So risk-based thinking is used all over the process approach to decide how risk is addressed in determining the processes to enhance the process outputs and avoid unwanted results. It is also used to improve the effectiveness of the quality management system. PDCA is a four-stage method that enables teams to avoid recurring mistakes and improve processes. So PDCA stands for Plan, Do, Check, and Act. Plan. It consists of smaller steps to build a proper plan with fewer possibilities of failures. While do, it applies everything that has been considered during the previous stage. Next, check, it will the audit plan execution and see if the initial plan is worked. And last one, act, proceed and apply initial plan, where it adopt the whole plan if objectives are met. Okay. In plan. Okay, the steps in process approach, there are six steps, but I will explain, just go through because there are so many. So there are steps in the process approach, what to do and guidance. So for plan, the steps, the first one is define the scope, objective and policies of the organization. So it do on the assessment of the requirements, need and expectations, determine the scope, objective and policies. Okay, the organization shall determine the scope, limits and applicability of its management system, taking into consideration the internal and external context. Okay, the second one, it determine the processes in the organization, where it determine the process needed to meet the objective and policies and to produce the expected outputs. The management should determine the processes needed for reaching the expected outputs, where it include management, resources, operations, measurements, assessment and improvement. The third one, it determines the sequence of the process, where it determines how the processes flow in the sequence and iteration. So it involves the inputs and outputs of each process, process iteration and interfaces on which process depend or enable, and it risks to the effectiveness of process iteration. Okay. The next one, it defines people who take process ownership and accountability, where it assigns responsibility and authority for each process. Top management should organize and define ownership, accountability in the world, individual roles, responsibilities, working groups, authority, and ensure the competence needed for the effective definition, implementation, maintenance, and improvement. Okay. The fifth one, it define the need for documented information, where it determine those processes that need for documented information. So the process occur within the organization that may be formal or informal. So for example, there are four. The first one is the size of organization and its type of activities, the complexity of its processes and their interactions, the criticality of the processes, and the need for formally accountability of performance. The last one is define the interfaces, risks, and activities within the process. Okay. It determines where and how monitoring and measuring should be applied. This should be both for control and improvement of the processes, and it also determines the need for recording results. So other factors are monitoring and measuring criteria, reviews of performance, interested parties satisfaction, supplier performance, on-time delivery and lead times, failure rates and weights, process costs, and incident frequency. Okay. For do, there are two steps, which is implement and define the resources. So the first one, implement. It implement action required to accomplish planned activities and results. So the organization should perform activities, monitoring, measures and controls of defined processes and procedures, outsourcing and other methods to achieve the planned results. So for the next one, it defined the resources need. It determined the resources needed for the effective operation of each process. Okay, the example of resources are human resources, which is HR, infrastructures, environment, information, natural resources, materials, and financial resources. Okay, for check, there is only one step, which is verify the process against its planned objectives. So it confirmed that the process is effective and that the characteristics of the processes are stable with the objective. So the organization should compare output against objective to verify that all the requirements are satisfied. So the examples are measurement, monitoring, reviews, audits, performance analysis. So these examples are to gather the data. Thank you.
Next, we will move on to the discussion, which is why ISO 9001 is important. ISO 9001 is very important for the startup organization in their careers. Firstly, competitive salary is one of the important of ISO 9001. It is an ability to leverage ISO 9001 credibility will allow us to win more tenders and contracts, while increasing productivity will enable us to satisfy and keep clients. Next, it is also enhancing through the reputation of the company. It is also a standard when organizations are searching for new supplier to provide a QMS based on ISO 9001, particularly for those in the public sector. Besides, it is improve the satisfaction of consumer. We can enhance consumer through in our ability to offer good and service by knowing the needs of our customer and reducing mistakes. We also can make a better efficiency of the service by following industry best performance and growth on quality so that we can ensure so that we can reduce the cost. We are able to boost decision making, which means we can easily detect possible issues to ensure we can take action quickly to eliminate the same errors in the future. Greater employer engagement. It can achieve when we are guaranteed that everyone is working on a one agenda by enhancing employer relations. It makes them happy and more efficient by engaging workers in developing process change. Next, the product service are guaranteed once an organization is ISO certified no matter what. This improves the security of the product service used by common individual. As we know, a culture of perpetual improvement is the third principle of ISO 9001. It means we are incorporate a comprehensive approach to the assessment and utilization of available resource increase. Last but not least, the other important is better partnership between supplier. It happens when we are able to utilize the best practice procedure, contribute to more profitable product, and our supplier will be marked by licensor. Next, we will move on to the conclusion. At the end of this session, we are able to establish effective quality management in an organization. We also understand as a guiding principle that can be used to create efficiency by aligning and streamlining process throughout the organization. Lastly, we are also to know how to lower the cost and create a new opportunities that meet regulator requirements and help organizations expand into new market in which client demand ISO 9001 certification. That's all from us. Thank you.